We'll start this session now. So good morning to everyone. So previously we had a discussion on the uplink, right? Still we have not gone in detail with the channel mapping and all other stuff. So we have observed the just what is the channel coding processing and what is the modulation processing and what is the mapping. Right. So what are the different channels available, how it is going to be mapped into these different channels. So we have a physical channel, we have a transport channel, and we have a logical channel. So you might be observing now in this, because if you take a computer communication network, when we are doing the lab, right, so when you are using that NS2 part, so your data, it was at the physical layer, right, this channel, and you are going to use two agents. One was TCP agent and one was UDP agent, right? And these two protocols will be using the logical channel. Hope if you remember the diagram which we are drawing, so it was the logical link which we were trying to establish. Right, and now we have to observe, there we were having file transfer protocol or a constant bitrate or a telnet or a simple mail or some other stuff we were trying to add. Now here in this channel, these are the different logical channels which are mapped for our uplink. Right, so uplink shared channel, and this is your physical uplink shared channel, and these are the different logical channels which has been supported. Like we have the shared part, we have the data part, we have a transport part. So all these things will be attached to these channels and it will be processed. Now in this, one important concept is your frequency hopping. So why this frequency hopping requires? Because so every time you are not able to check, okay, so randomly you are going to check whether these nodes are active or not. Okay, so how you are going to identify that one? So every odd number you are going, because it is not possible for the network to check each and every packet. Okay, so out of 100 packet is going to normally check around 10, so we will be assuming that 1/100 times, right? So which is nothing but your every 10th symbol I am going to check whether it is active or not, because obviously we know that when I want to check each and every packet, it is going to take lot more time, right? And to avoid all these things, what we done is that we go for this frequency hopping, right? So LTE supports frequency hopping on physical uplink shared channel, which provides additional frequency diversity gain in the uplink. Frequency hopping can also provide the interface averaging when system is not 100% loaded. Okay, so in LTE, both intra subframe and inter subframe frequency hopping is supported. So in these images, you can observe that these are some frequency hopping which they have done, right? And to do this also, there is a pattern which is going to follow. Usually the pattern which they are going to follow is the based on the number of types which is presented. So we have observed in the downlink also, we have three different types where it is going to identify with the help of odd number and with the help of even number, right? Using this pattern only is going to identify the things. Okay, so these frequency hopping part only we have to understand. So again, it will give an option for us whether we want to go for either no frequency hopping or with the help of a frequency hopping. So again, it is with respect to the control field which is going to happen. So no frequency hopping, so FH value will be 0. Frequency hopping, FH value will be 1. And in this frequency hopping, there are two types. So you can observe that type is 1 and there is type 2, right? So it is going to go for the format 0 DCI, which is your control information, data control information, which is going to apply. So here you observe that there what you call the frame format, which pin should be on, which pin should be off, which is activated, which is not activated. So those all information you can observe here. So in this you can observe that if the single bit frequency hop field is the corresponding physical data link shared channel with a DSA format of 0 is set to 1, the UA shall perform PUSCH frequency hopping, otherwise no frequency hopping is performed. Means you need to indicate whether we need to do this frequency hopping or not. Why frequency hopping is required? Because for all the frequency it is not required to check it, right? So whichever it is free, those channels we need to take. Because take an example of a traffic as an example. So if you know that this is a common route and traffic is more, whether you will wait in the traffic, all right, you are going to choose some alternate path. So alternate path when you are choosing, so there should be some guarantee that it will reach to the destination. So obviously what method we follow is that we'll use the Google map and we'll identify that which path we should take so that we will reach the destination. The work, the practice, what we follow there, this also follows the same thing, right? But prior you need to indicate that what it should be there. Why we have to give this? Because he will measure the probability of that efficiency. Okay, so this is the expression which is going to calculate, right? So how much time it is going to take from this route or this path to reach to the destination. So those all calculation will be done, and if you agree to transmit your data into that channel, then it will be possible. Otherwise it is not going to happen. The UE first determine the allocated resource block after applying all the frequency hopping rules, and then data is mapped onto these resources. So it is not that, oh, this is free, so we will let transmit data into this part. So it will ask whether this is a new one, whether it is a trusted one, whether data has been formatted or not, what is the frame format of that structure, what are the rules, because we follow that protocol, we call that, whether it is going to follow that one, and everything when it is been applicable, then we are going to use this frequency hop concept for transmitting our data. So next comes your multi-antenna transmission. So again, as we observed in the downlink part, so here also we have the two part. One is open loop antenna transmission, one is closed loop antenna transmission, and one more is your no antenna transmission, right? So why these concepts has arise? Because now everyone are talking about this multiple input and multiple output, right? So you observe that we have n number of input data which are coming into our resources, and these data should be mapped according to their requirement, and it should be provided to its destination appropriately, right? So earlier what you should do, only I should able to correct the data, only I should open that path, I should verify those things. So now it is not with respect to all those things. Now you observe that scenario with respect to the college, right? So college, any information it is there, they will give to the principal, but all work only principal cannot do, right? So that is why what they will distribute their workload into the different branches. Like for EC, we have EC HOD, CAC HOD. So we have multiple branch, multiple HODs here. Now HODs also cannot work, cannot take all the workload on themselves, right? So what they do, they will allocate the faculty members to for that particular class based on the subject availability and their domain. Means what, you are dividing out all those stuff, right? So here we have multiple inputs which you have provided and multiple, because this is a hierarchy which we are going to follow. Maybe in the QCA meeting you might have observed that, so main principal sir will be there, HOD sir will be there, IQC coordinator will be there, then your class teacher will be there, subject teacher will be there, then students will be there. So students, you have to raise there any issues if is there, so that will be taken care by all these authorities which are being present over there, right? And they will follow some hierarchy to solve those issues if anything it has been raised. So you have multiple inputs which has been given to this one, and this will be efficiently done. See, in the QCA meeting also you observe that there is only half an hour allocated. Within this half an hour, first year, second year, third year, everything. So they should log in, they should log out. And to that particular time they should log in, to a particular time they should log out. So that their efficiency and everything, it will be proper, right? And for the, all those things, what it is that you are not knowing whether what is working or why, which is working, whether I am in correct group or not, everything it is allocated, right? So your faculties will be there. So you will come to, oh, now 8th A section, it is going on, right? So if 8th B students also is there, so they will wait for some amount of time. After 8th A is completed, again they will rotate to the 8th B. Now you take an example of your IA also, right? You observe that previous semester or previous year, we were having this online examination. So which subject was there? So those faculty were present and they were monitoring the class, right? So they will be thinking that, so your faculty, your subject, so they will be liberal, they will not do, or they will not work efficiently. Now what they have done? So they have given all their link. So no need to intimate all those things. So give that information PDF link to your students. So student will join, faculty will be there, he will be present there, he will open that link and he will do. So very systematically it is with process, right? So there is no hassle free, there is nothing information. So prior they are giving information to you how it should be processed. Now observe that over complete around 400 people from our branch, and there is not anyone, a single issue has been raised. Sir, I have gone into other group and all those things. Whatever issues were there, it was solved as and when then only itself. One more example I would like to share is that yesterday also there was IA for the lower semester. So by default or by mistakenly, I was not having duty, but in the PDF they had put my link, right? So around 2 o'clock, I'm getting a call that, sir, your link, you have not joined, kindly join. And I have observed that my duty is not there, already I have done. So instead of some ex faculty, they have allocated to me. And it took only for me around 5 minutes of time to put this information to the coordinator. So coordinator identified the mistake, he replaced that link with a new link, and he uploaded into that part, and within 5 minutes, that issue was solved. Means why I'm telling this, because now we have this multiple resources and multiple input where your data can be routed into your wish. Means what? Your connection will be established within a minute or fraction of a time. Only thing is that you should be well versed of what link or what data you should be placing. Right? That is a main priority in this part which you need to observe. Now almost all the things will be of this multi-antenna transmission only. As earlier I said that you will be not having Airtel antenna or BSNL antenna, or there will be Jio antennas. So antenna will be common. Resources you are going to utilize from that. And for that one, network provider will provide rental to the government for that. I'm going to use this many resources. I'm going to use this many antennas for my transmission, for which I'm going to pay. Right? And this is how they are going to do. So hardware and everything, it is taken care by the government. It is not built by the private part. Right. Considering the cost and complexity of the user equipment, LTE only supports a limited number of multi-antenna transmission scheme in a pick. One is transmit antenna selection, one is multi-user MIMO. Right. So transmit antenna selection, again there are three different types: no antenna selection, closed loop selection, open loop selection. Right. So what is this closed loop, what is this open loop, if you want to identify, is that closed loop and open loop, right? So best example again I will give with this Teams app. So earlier, prior to this, I have created this my own team with subject title as 17EC81 for WC LTE. So I am the owner for that one, and HOD is one more owner, and all students belonging to 8th A have been added as a member, right? So this is specific part. So whatever information or whatever I put in the chat message, right, or in the activity, you can observe that it is only going to these persons only, right? Earlier you were having 8A as a group, and this 8A group, you are having multiple subjects, okay, like 81 subject, like 82 subject, like 83 subject. Now what happens when I put a message? So that message was been observed not only by all the members but also other faculties also. Why? Because it was a open loop, means it was a common part, because we have built branches in these type, okay. This we call it as a open loop type, and closed loop type, it is like my own separate kind of a thing, because it will be in the closed loop for transmission of the data which has been observed. So these are few examples which are present here. So transmitter antenna selection with two or more antenna at the user equipment, transmit antenna selection can be applied, which is able to provide spatial diversity gain. Multi antenna transmission at the user equipment depends upon the signaling from the higher layers. So there are three types: low antenna selection, if transmit antenna selection is disabled or not supported by UE, the UE shall transmit from transmit port 0, which is the default value, right? So even if I am not able to make a call and all those stuff which will be there, but still you are able to transmit by the default thing. But that is not applicable in your mobile phone. If there is no currency, then you are not able to make a call. So if you want to make a call, it should be through the internet. So when I wanted to use the internet, in the internet also, if there is a minimum balance of 1 rupee or something, then only your internet works. Otherwise, that is also not working, right? Because we want to make a call using through a normal call or through a internet call. So now it is all changing to a VoIP, right? Voice over IP internet protocol, which we are going to have. So another 6 or 1 year down the line, so no calling features, everything, it will be by company itself, they will disable. Why they are going to disable that thing? Because the main reason being the power. Okay, the main issue with this one of a normal calling is with respect to the power. So, and we feel, or the a user will feel, that the power factor is the one which is annoying to all the users, right? So my battery power and all those stuff. So when I use this internet part, so all this process of data transmission will be taking place. You may be thinking, sir, if I make internet on, so the device, it will get heated up and all those stuff. Now you observe, earlier it was getting heated and all the other stuff. Now from morning to evening, if it is there, still you are able to transmit your data. That is the advancement which they have got. Advantages, again, it is that you can make call to anybody. But the only problem in these type of calls or internet voice over OP is that identification of the user is a bit difficult. And when they improve this security process, then everyone will start using this process, because they will not be able to identify the exact IP. Okay, now internet is connected, one IP is there, that is fine. Everywhere you are changing the network position, your IP address also, the IP number, not IP address of your device with respect to the connecting to the internet, it is going to change. Now I am into college network, so college IP address will be identified and it will be used, right? If I am at my home, so my mobile IP address, it is going to happen and it is going to be utilized. So there are many factors which is going to apply here, which we will be discussing. Okay. So MU, MI, MU, right? So MU stands for your multi-user, and MI, MU stands for your multiple input and multiple output in uplink, also referred to as virtual MIMO transmission. Two user equipment transport simultaneously on the same radio source, forming a virtual MIMO, and E not B separate the data for each user. Example, you are using multi-user detection. This technique provides a spatial multiplexing gain to increase the uplink spectrum efficiency even with the single antenna user equipment. Next comes your UCI, which is your uplink control information, right? So uplink control information, you should be knowing what type of information I need to transmit. Now I want to connect to all of you. So which is the best way I have to connect? So usually if I want to connect through a class, so I have to use this Teams app, and I have to intimate to you that this class I'm going to take during this time and it will be activated, right? So what is the frequency of this one? What is the time duration of this one? Because usually when I will be connecting through WebEx or through Google Meet, so it will give the link, and if I go for a WebEx part, it will give for the meeting ID along with the meeting password. Okay, so why these two requirement is there? Because they have not added me to their group. So I am acting as an external person who is going to join to that group. And when I want to join to that particular group, I have to give meeting ID along with a password. But here you observe that there is no meeting ID or there is no password. There is only a link which is given. Why? Because I have added individually all the using your mail IDs, have joined to the group. So once I join to your group, there is no authentication required for you join the part. Now you observe that if I don't join exactly at 9 o'clock, so if I have not started the meeting also, you student, you yourself can start the meeting, because when you try to join, automatically this meeting will open. Okay, and I have not set any password for that one. Maybe during your IA time, when I want to join, I will have to give for whoever wants to join this one, they should be taken permission from me who has created this as an organizer. So during IA time, whoever is there, I should permit them. Somebody is making a noise. Okay. Fine. So here you can observe that what is the control information, what type of modulation, what type of acknowledgement, how the scheduling request will be done, what is the rank indicator, what is the pre-coding matrix it is going to follow. So those information he has listed, right? So uplink control information is to assess physical layer procedure by providing the following types of physical layer control information, right? So what information it will do is that control quality indicator, right? That is CQI, which is going to be used. It is going to follow with the HARQ acknowledgement, which is associated with the, because what downlink procedure you are going to apply, same thing should be processed at the uplink also, right? If both are not matching, then obviously you are not able to upload any data. So for downloading something, you are using one type of internet. For uploading, one type of internet you are following? No. Right? For receiving, for sending messages, you are using message port number different? No, you are using the same thing. You may be, for calling, you are using a different mobile phone. For receiving, you are using a different mobile phone. That can be done. Okay. But for uploading, for downloading, you have to use a common thing. Right? Why we are using for calling two different mobile phone? Because of the call rate, right? So one it will be free, one it is chargeable. So that is why we are using dual SIM, for one for transmitting, for one for receiving. As earlier I said that now the government is making a strict policy that you have to use only one. Still it is not came into existence, but in future you will be linked with everything. Now you observe that for all your mobile phone, it is linked to your Aadhaar card, it linked to your PAN number, linked to your account number, so linked to your UPI. So everything it is been done. If you have any other number also, it should be mapped. Otherwise, you will be facing some difficulties. Okay. So that is what you have to understand. So this is what I wanted to tell you. Whatever we follow, we at the downlink type, same thing we are going to follow at the uplink type also. Acknowledgement will be having, schedule request will be having, pre-coding matrix indicator, so that we have observed, right? Preferred pre-coding matrix also it can be seen. So this can be observed using uplink control information UCI, and your physical channel is your physical uplink shared channel and control channel. So both it is been mapped. Okay, so your UCI, it is mapped for your control channel also, and UCI is mapped to your shared channel. So by default, PUSCH, which is your shared channel, it is mapped for all the channels. Okay, control information, which is the information which you need to be transmitted. See, some information principal will forward to the HODs. HODs will select for whom it has to be reached, and they will forward to the particular faculties. Now those faculties will particularly forward to their groups, right? So that is what we follow. Example, the collection of fees, those who have not paid the fees. So only those particular faculty class teacher will put a message to those particular student identifying that so and so person which has been not done. Right? Now to have more interaction with the student and the faculties, because now it is all online and everything. So physically we are not meeting. Right? So we don't know what you are thinking. We don't know that whether our information is reaching to you or not. Right? Now what they did is that, so it is very difficult for one faculty to control all 60 people. Now what they have done is that they have given that responsibility to the mentors. Right? So your counseling students, so there will be 25 people in a particular faculty, so that faculty will be easily able to identify. So that is what it was there. So now you can observe that the July end month they will be having examination for 8th semester and 1st semester students. Is it done? So VTI has circulated that. So within first week of July, vaccination should be provided to all the students so that they can take up the examination in an offline mode. That is the circular which they have been allocated. Now class teacher doing all the work, it will take a lot of time to communicate to individual student. So they ask the mentors to do this job. So what I had done is that yesterday I put a circular to them, and I inquired with all my counseling student whether how many of you have taken vaccination, how many of you have not taken. And based on that data, I instructed that those who have not taken the vaccination, they need to come to the college and take the vaccination, which is a free of cost. So that is how they have made the task into a simpler things. Okay, they have made the task. So that is what few of the things it will be shared, and few of the things which will be controlled information, and all information will be not provided to everyone, because chances of misusing the data is more possible. And that is why, to avoid all those things, they will follow these steps. So I hope you will be understanding what is a control information and what is a shared information with respect to the UCI. So these contents, right? So UCI on physical uplink control channel. So when a UCI is transmitted to the physical uplink control channel, three channel coding scenarios are considered. So one is CQI and PMI, but not HARQ acknowledgement, right? So few datas which will be there, for which you require only pass on information, no acknowledgement is required. Now about fees and all those things, you require acknowledgement from the student. For vaccination, you require an acknowledgement. Now if there is any competition, so if I want to transmit that information, I will put that information to the group. So who is interested, they will respond. Who is not interested, they will not respond, right? But vaccination and other fees part, it is mandatory that everyone should reply, because that is mandatory for. So based on some particular control information, you can tell that whether an acknowledgement is required, whether an acknowledgement is not required. Okay, so UCI contains CQ and all those stuff. Encoding CQ and PQ is encoded using the 20 NCQ. What is this 20 NCQ is? Your frequency hopping will be of 20 variables. So I will just show you an image. So this is, you can observe that it is going to start with 0 and it is going to start with 19. So there is nothing but a 20 variables. Okay. Basic sequence of a 20, N code, right? So this is a code word assigned for each of the channel which is going to be transmitted. So this control information and all the stuff, again we will be discussing in the tomorrow's class. Okay, I'll stop it. I've taken 5 minutes extra because 5 minutes it was delayed, so only I will extend it to 9:45. I've taken the attendance. Again, tomorrow's session we will continue with this topic. Okay, anything you want to ask, anything you want to share, you can ask it. Otherwise, I'll just end the session now. One more thing, why I'm ending soon is because 9:55 I have one more class. Okay, so if there is no questions, means I'll just wind up. Okay, we'll stop recording.